for all those who were preaching, for all those who were mocking me on social media, for all those who put out memes of me on social media, for all those who are questioning why am I getting into their private space and putting out WhatsApp chats, for all those busy making all of these jokes on me, I just have one thing to say. I let my work to respond. Ladies and gentlemen, detractors and cynics, tonight facts and investigations that I have put out on the news are each night today has spoken. Watch this before I elaborate further on why Bollywood must take note and course correct. Take a look at this package. Chat number one, and this is a chat that was deleted by Riya Chakrabarty from her phone. In case we speak about hard drugs, I haven't been doing too much according to, and she says, MDMA is something she's tried once. Use 4 drops in coffee, tea or water and let him sip it. The interrogation files of the Narcotics Control Bureau have named 3 biggies of the Bollywood drug mafia nexus. Name number 1, Sara Ali Khan. Name number 2, Rakul Preet Singh. And name number 3, Simon Khambata. Hello, I'm sending across the CBD oil with the Gina today. Hey, thank you. Shraddha says to Jaya Sahad, and Jaya says thank you with an emoji there. Look at this. Right here in this green chat is the name with D. This is the name, ladies and gentlemen, and let me expand it some more for you. This is the WhatsApp chat that is between Deepika Padukone. Well, ladies and gentlemen, right from 25th of August when I first put out the drug chats that exposed the drug ring that had been operating right under the nose of the most influential industry in the country and the best police force, which was compared to Scotland Yard. With proof in black and white, several B-Town apologists and A-listers targeted me, abused me, mocked me on social media. But today, I would like to tell them just one thing. You don't want to answer my questions? That's fine. You don't want to explain your actions to me? That's fine too. You don't want me to reveal why you wanted mal, weed and hash? Well, I really don't know and I have nothing to do with it. That's also fine. But now that the long arm of the law has finally caught up with you, there is no choice but to sit at the Narcotic Control Bureau's office in Mumbai for hours and hours and explain your actions to them. Deepika Padukone, Shraddha Kapoor, Sara Ali Khan, Rakul Preet Singh, Simon Khambata, all exposed right here on the News Hour for weeks when I've been working on this investigation. And I've never put out anything without hard proof, ladies and gentlemen. You want to joke about the WhatsApp chats that I have put out? Joke about it. Make as many memes that you want to make on it. The fact is, these were part of the investigations and I was reporting these facts because it's my dharma as a journalist to put out the facts in public domain. This is not my agenda against B-Town. This is not what I want to say about B-Town. This is about what's going on, what's being investigated, who are the people who are being looked at. And each point exposed here on the News Hour with facts and with evidence. Evidence that was under the scanner with investigation agencies. Now, all that these people who have been summoned by the Narcotics Control Bureau will have to explain why they were texting and pleading desperately for drugs. In the next 3 days, all these A-listers, along with others who are part of this circuit, will be questioned and cross-questioned. Viewers, today I want to make it clear. This is not about one doobie, one incident, or a few grams of drugs. This is about busting a nefarious drug circle which is ruining the future of our country, our youngsters. They could be your children, they could be mine. They could be our nephews, nieces, brothers, sisters. But it is our next generation. This is about exposing and punishing those who are directly or indirectly responsible for Sushant Singh Rajput's death. This is about unraveling and uprooting the circle of ruin and death and ensuring that there will be no other Sushant Singh Rajput. No Rajputs will die in mysterious circumstances, not in Bollywood and not outside Bollywood, because outside Bollywood there are many who look at all of you, all of these A-listers in Bollywood as their icons, their role models. This is about them. This is about that cleanup. I don't mind if you say that there are only a few in Bollywood who do this. Fine, at least admit that there is a problem. There is a problem that requires some amount of handling and cleanup. But to say, aisa yahan hota hi nahi, is to be in denial, and that is a denial India will not accept. Today, it's not my conscience which is unclear. Today, all of Bollywood needs to answer their conscience, and they need to answer the conscience of India, and they need to answer questions of the investigation agencies. So, ladies and gentlemen, the legitimate question on the News Hour tonight is, will Mal Lobby issue an apology to Times Now and to me? Because I've been ridiculed and said that I'm making a mountain out of a molehill. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I was doing my job. And today, when the summons have gone out to all of the people who I have named, I rest my case. But the debate coming up on the other side.